Hi everybody, my name is Antoinette and this is Board Game Inquisition, where we're here to offer you insights and indeed information about the board games you might just want to have in your own collection. So are you in the mood to push your logic to its limits? Well, if so, then here's five things I think you need to know about Cryptid. A cryptid is a creature whose existence cannot be substantiated or is in fact disputed. And in this game of the same name, you are trying to locate the cryptid, using only your wits and the clues you're given. On your turn, you can glean information from the other players to help you solve the puzzle by asking them questions.
Could the cryptid be here?
The winner is the first person to uncover the cryptid's secret location. Thing 1, what's this game all about? Well, Cryptid is an abstract strategy game, so it doesn't really have much of a theme. More so, it has an idea, this notion of a cryptid, which is a creature whose existence cannot be verified or substantiated. And I think that's an interesting concept to base a logic puzzle around, because that is what you're getting here. A series of, you know, deductions and logical inferences to help you discover the location of this cryptid. But I do think combining logic with that kind of idea of, let's say, something like the Yeti or the Abominable Snowman or of course, you know, the Loch Ness Monster, is a nice way of making logic seem fun and interesting. Now, similar titles to this, this is going to be a tough one. I do not have many deduction games, but for some reason, it reminds me a little bit of something like Spyfall, which is the case where everybody has their own piece of information and you have to ask each other questions to, you know, infer truth from them. So in that sense, maybe they're a little bit similar. Perhaps you have better suggestions, and if you do, pop them off in the comment box below for everyone else to read. Thing 2, what will you be doing while playing this game? So, Cryptid is very light mechanically, but I really like how it's put together. So what's going to happen is each player will be given a clue as to the location of the cryptid. And these come from a booklet of clues, so there are tons and tons of different types for every time you play. And this clue will refer to certain parts of the board to tell you where your cryptid might be located. You're not given the full amount of information. But because everyone has a clue, the idea is that you will ask questions of your opponents to try and determine where the cryptid is between your various clues. And these yet again refer to places on the board. So you can point to the board and say, could the cryptid be here? And everyone must answer truthfully. And so that's how the gameplay goes till you solve the puzzle. There's something unusual about this game in the sense that yes, you are playing for an individual win, but it does feel quite cooperative because you can see and hear the answers to everyone else's question. And these kind of incorrect answers are marked on the board also, so you can track back and say, well, it can't have been here, it can't have been there, maybe it could have been there. So in a sense, you are kind of working together. But I really, really like that feeling. It feels like you are a group of hunters going to track down the Abominable Snowman, and you're helping each other until one of you is the eventual winner. But I liked it very much how it fit together like that. The other important thing about this game is the clues and the fact that you have to be honest in your answering. And there's many times when I have accidentally lied because I've misread my clue or I read the wrong one. It is easy to slip up like that. And there is no way to catch if somebody has really made an error until it's too late. Now, fortunately, the game is fairly short to play. So, you know, you can kind of get over that and just start again. But it is something you need to be conscious of because that single clue is private and it's so important to gameplay that you really do have to get it right. Overall, yeah, this game is definitely light, but how it's put together is incredibly smart. When you see it all unfold in front of you, you realise just how genius actually it is. And it somehow, in the midst of all of this, manages to make logic feel fun. Thing 3, what's this game like on the table? Well, once you've got Cryptid out of the box and all laid out, it actually doesn't take up a bunch of space. But it is clearly an abstract strategy game, you can tell from how it looks. And I kind of like how it looks. It's a bit wacky, a bit crazy. It'll definitely have people coming over and asking you what it is for sure. Now, setup is actually quick and easy because you get these little cards and they will explain to you the order in which the board should be set up for the main game. And then on the back, it will tell you which booklets all the different clues come from for the various players. So it makes it quick and easy to get it all going. Playtime for two of us is about 10 minutes, but it definitely changes depending on how difficult the clue is or, you know, that all that kind of stuff. And the rule book that comes with this is very, very good as well. Replayability, well, there's lots here because, well, it's a puzzle, but there are also such a range and variety of questions and, you know, clues that you've been given that you really could play a lot of this for a long time. Thing four, how does this game look and feel? Well, I'm not going to lie, I'm really impressed by the box art for Cryptid. It really reminds me of some kind of old school horror poster. And I love that they try to inject a bit of kind of fun and theme and energy into a game that is essentially just, you know, solving a puzzle. So I really, really like that. Now, unfortunately, there is no other art in the game itself, but what you do get in the box is an explosion of colour. And I think it really elevated this game and made it always feel kind of fun and whimsical by the use of those kind of crazy bold colours. Overall, the component quality here is very, very good, and Cryptid as a whole is a nicely put together game, and it's kind of nice to look at. Thing five, is this game actually any good? Well, I can count on my left hand the number of deduction games I own, and I include social deduction ones in that title, simply because they're just not my thing. And despite having passed two different logic courses in my lifetime, I'm still not overly comfortable hopping from one truth to another. Now, Cryptid, however, is definitely different. I think it might be to do with how the clues are put together, because they definitely make you feel like you're very, very close to figuring all of this out. They don't feel like a hindrance, they feel more like a help. And of course, you know, you don't have to do this alone because other people are playing with you. And on your turn, you will glean information that you want to ask, but you can also learn things from other people, from the type of questions they're asking, and from the questions and answers that they're getting. And I think that's really, really cool. And I love the fact that you can simply kind of copy someone else's train of thought if you're not sure where to go. Keep an eye on the person that's one step ahead of you and see maybe what they're trying to think. So that's pretty, pretty fun. Now, I think the best part of this game is the fact that it's so visual and you're watching a logic puzzle fold in visual space. I think that was brilliant for my brain to be able to play this because you didn't have to keep all the negative and positive things that people had said up in your brain. No, it lays itself out on the table before you. And of course, the board evolves as you play and discover more things. And I think that was just so amazing and helpful to see logic kind of unfold like that. Was fantastic. So I think that makes this game a little bit more appealing to people who maybe were a little nervous about it being a logic game in the first place. Making it visual is incredibly helpful. So I think, I suppose another one of my favourite features about this is watching people play Cryptid. It's kind of hilarious because it is a puzzle, right? So you instantly get to see how other people would approach a puzzle. And that's kind of cool. I learned a lot about my friends while playing this and about how they approach the issue at hand compared to me. And it was kind of really exciting and entertaining. Because Cryptid is a really unusual and unique game, and it's one I think you're going to keep memories with long after you've put the game back on the shelf. I know I certainly will. Overall, I'm really surprised by this because this isn't a game I should like at all, but I've really fallen in love with. Have you figured out if Cryptid is for you yet? Well, if you want something that's quick and easy to play, that involves you solving puzzles and figuring stuff out, this is the kind of game you should enjoy. You've been watching Board Game Inquisition. You should like or subscribe to this channel so you can get updates about future videos. Or if you have any comments or queries you'd like to make about Cryptid, just shout them off in the comment box below. And tune in again next time for some more short and informative board game reviews. Take care, everybody.